CAST is the Center for Autonomous System Technology at Caltech. It's a place where Caltech and JPL scientists and students and researchers come together in order to define a new vision for researching autonomous systems from basic science to applications.
Right now, there's a big push towards autonomy in general. Autonomy on robotic systems, autonomy in cars. You have machine learning, robotics, computer vision, all of these areas coming together. And CAST is a way of really trying to address central problems in this theme in a way that's interdisciplinary in an environment that can't really be duplicated at other universities.
My area of research is artificial intelligence and machine learning, and more specific to CAST are these areas of reinforcement learning. So I've been talking to Aaron Ames about having these bipedal robots be able to adapt to any kind of surface and ultimately be autonomously able to walk.
One of the challenges of getting robots to work robustly in the wild is that it needs to be able to deal with unforeseen circumstances and unknown environments, right? So in the lab, everything is well controlled, everything is well sensed, and we know everything there is to know. But in order to deal with a lot of heterogeneity, we need to be able to develop a better mind to put into these robots. Mind is where I come in. I work in artificial intelligence and machine learning, and so I'm going to put the mind into the body.
It's not just making fancier drones and robots or developing softwares that work alone, but the point is to bring these two together in order to make them more effective in helping the human scientists to do their job better.
We've been using drones and other UAVs to study Earth surface processes in a range of different places. Technology is enabling a couple of different things. One, the ability to explore environments that are just impossible for us to go. For example, the subsurface oceans on some of Jupiter's moons. Additionally, there are all kinds of places that we would like to be all the time, but we can't be because we're here, we have to multitask, and there are interesting and important things happening in the environment, and we want the opportunity to discover those. I think what is going to make CAST special is a partnership where we're actually going to be able to start with questions that are motivated by scientific problems. We're not just grabbing off-the-shelf technologies, we're going to develop approaches that actually are well-suited to specific types of science problems.
The CAST facility is actually remarkable, right? We have this amazing wind tunnel that could generate incredibly complex wind conditions to be able to test some of these challenges. And downstairs, Professor Chung has a state-of-the-art lab where they simulate microfriction.
I'm standing in my new spacecraft research lab where we are going to have a frictionless spacecraft simulator. Basically, they are floating on the very high precision surface and where we can actually implement advanced guidance, control, and autonomy algorithms. By the end of this year, we'll have 5 spacecraft simulators for swarms of spacecraft research. The idea is that you have this collection of spacecraft work together so that they can form certain particular shape. Like flying one drone, then maybe you have to worry about the collision with respect to the obstacles. But now you have maybe 2 or maybe thousands of these drones, then you also have to consider collision avoidance. So it becomes a little more complicated, but once you figure out the math and the algorithmic detail, then you can actually achieve all these benefits of the swarm technology.
In the tradition of Caltech, we are in the business of taking the high-risk challenges. From LIGO to landing on Mars, we have not been deterred by the level of challenges. So CAST is, in the same tradition, going to really embark on solving challenges in autonomous system technologies. This is a long-term dream that has come true.